going on there. It was really intense.
It was really good. Yesterday all our class went to the First World War Museum with Professor Waller and Luciana Gottardi was with you at the Mark Museum. And we did a course about the figure of Mussolini, that is the boss of fascism. And we talk about propaganda, we talk about the army, we talk about how the soldiers live in the trinchee, that are buildings on the floor in which all the soldiers live during the war.
I want to start from the museum, not from the bus.
Okay. Do you think it's important to have museums with the bus?
Yeah, I think it was an important experience when we went to the museum, because we went to the museum, I didn't know a lot about fascism and Mussolini, and after the visit I knew a lot more.
We went to Damanhur, which is an intentional community close to Milan, where they had dug out these unbelievable temples of humanity by hand.
Damanhur is, it's a community of people who are not necessarily like-minded, but all are open to different ideas. So, in a way, it's a grouping of very, very different people who all have a similar goal. And they paint nature on their buildings, like big, huge, massive bugs and leaves, and when we asked why, they said it was so that they could feel as if they were part of nature, and so they could live in it rather than like beside it or away from it. The temples of humanity were something that they built. They began building, I guess, about 30 years ago, and they started illegally. And they had owned the property, and they decided that this hillside was a good place to build a temple, dig a hole. And so they began with shovels and buckets, and they did it all by hand.
So where is it again?
I don't need... There was like over 5 million buckets or something ridiculous like that that they dug out of the ground. And like chain, like past the bucket to the dump truck type thing.
And
and they ended up building this huge, this amazing temple, and they cemented the insides and mosaicked the floors and stained glass ceilings and painted life and like just existence.
Being inside the temples of humankind, I learned that we believe in each other, immensely. We all have so much faith and power and possibility. We have the power to open up the most beautiful parts of others, and we have the power to light up the hidden parts of our own exquisite essence.
We took the train to Venice on Friday. It was seriously blew our minds. The idea of a city built on water with canals and beautiful architecture everywhere was just outrageous. We visited St. Mark's Square and the old, old, old cathedral, which everyone found beautiful and astounding, whatever their religion. We saw many people dressed up for Carnival as well, and they had the most elaborate and eccentric costumes, and there were masks everywhere.
When we went to Venice and went into the amazing cathedral with all its beautiful stone god depictions that were so indescribable that it made me really stop and think. In that moment, standing in front of the most beautiful display of workmanship and insane dedication, I felt myself forgiving religion a bit. Even though religion has caused us so much grief and pain, anything that could grab something inside us that makes us want to dedicate our entire lives to creating something to honor it cannot be all bad. The human capacity to believe and have faith is truly exquisite.
How, when you place people out of their home and put them somewhere new, some people will change and some will not. Some of us went out into the new and found a whole new place to sit. Almost a whole new part of themselves was being exposed. I understand that the ability to change and adapt to your environment is essential for happiness. To learn to live and live well with what is around you, what you can find, and what other people are willing to share with you. I understand that the world is small, and it is ours.
I feel as getting to be on this trip in itself was an obstacle because there is so much holding us back in terms of deadlines for passports, money, everything. It just seemed like an ultimate impossibility. That when we actually got to Italy, we were all astounded and so happy with everyone and ourselves. I feel like we found peace in ourselves because we were so in the moment and present. I don't think I had any true obstacles with peace, but the biggest thing I had to keep in mind on this trip was that I had to keep reflecting and focusing on why we were really there. It was so easy to get swept up into the lives and shindigs of the Italians that there were sometimes it was hard to focus on the tough stuff. I found it really important to write in my journal every night and recap on the crazy, amazing things we had experienced and seen.
Being there made me feel like, made me excited to live the rest of my life. Just experience it, being out in the world and seeing everything and not necessarily having to love it and not necessarily having to have it really, really speak to me. But being so interested by it and meeting people who are so strange and yet so normal and some, like, just huge differences. And it's just so exciting to see and be like, oh, wow, okay, I can think differently about that now.
Friendships don't have limits. You don't need years to get to know someone. You don't need to speak their language to understand them. You don't need to have the same history to feel connected. You only need a shared goal, a hope, some beautiful manifestations, and really excellent coffee.
She once had me. She showed me her room. Isn't it good? Norwegian wood. She asked me to stay and she told me to sit anywhere. So I looked around and I noticed there wasn't a chair. I sat on the roof.
Tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be